We're back with George P. Bush talking about his decision to run for Texas Attorney General next year. Now, Commissioner, we recently saw Texas become the latest state to lose in the Supreme Court when it comes to challenging the Affordable Care Act. Is that something you'd try to take on and take on from a different angle, or what's your feeling on that?
Yeah, this is another example of how the current occupant is losing consistently in the court. So he lost on the election challenge case because there was no standing. And I had a chance to read the opinion earlier today on the Obamacare case, as you referenced. And we lost the case because we didn't have standing there. And for laymen out there and among your viewers, the state of Texas has to show damage and harm. And AG Paxton was unable to show that. In fact, even though the court is 6-3 constitutional conservative, we lost the case 7-2. Only two justices were willing to grant standing and actually get to the merits. So the merits of the case weren't actually litigated or even deliberated on by the Supreme Court. So as Attorney General, I would find that harm. There's certainly harm in having a government mandated healthcare policy in a great state like ours. And do more homework. I mean, the first day of law school, you're trained how to basically find standing so you can bring a case. And unfortunately, Ken has lost two of the biggest cases in the last year based on that first issue alone. For the layman, it's like if you're going to the airport, right, and you plan a very serious vacation, you bought the hotel rooms, you bought your air ticket, but you forgot your driver's license and you weren't able to make your flight. That's exactly what happened in the last two cases. You got to find standing before you get in the court.
Well, you've been a vocal supporter of former President Trump's. Attorney General Paxton also has. Given the weight that the former president still has within the Republican Party and among Republican voters, how much do you think you're going to try to court him? And how much do you think his endorsement will end up mattering in this race?
Well, you're right. I endorsed him in 2016, and I raised all the finances for Republican Party politics that year. And it was the high water mark. And when Bush's and Trump's come together, good things happen. I helped with the reelect in 2020. I've had a chance to visit with him three times since I announced. He congratulated me and the governor on the recent actions regarding securing our border in Texas moving forward and leading on this issue. And he reminded me that he was close to constructing the 750 miles, but for Joe Biden's executive orders. So he's watching this race very closely. I keep in regular contact with him. And he was very surprised to learn that as my first endorsement, I received the support of the National Border Patrol Council. This is the union that represents the 18,000 border agents that keep the watch every single day. So I'm definitely courting the support. He is the life of the Republican Party, and I would definitely welcome that endorsement.
There might be some people out there who just look at your name and think, okay, he's running for attorney general. He'd been land commissioner. So what's he going to run for next? Maybe this is just something to put on your resume before running for governor, president, you name it. So what would you say to those folks about your true interest in being attorney general?
What I've learned in the private sector and in the public sector is to focus on the mission, the here and the now. I see our state under attack in the courthouse. I see its values under attack from this president and the vice president. The best way that I can help right now is to serve as the attorney general of Texas. I have a proven track record. And with 2 years, if I'm able to win this race, I will be confronting the Biden-Harris agenda for a good 2 years. So there's enough on the plate right there to keep me busy. Plus, I got the day job of being land commissioner. And as I said, we're partnering with the governor to construct what we hope to be dozens, if not hundreds of miles of wall over the course of the next several months, if not years. So there's a lot on the plate right now. We will probably have two special sessions this summer. Ranging from power grid issues to election integrity. We have to come back and do redistricting sometime in September, and the land office will be involved in that potentially. So there's a lot on the plate and a lot to balance in terms of a statewide campaign, but also doing the day job.
Commissioner Bush, we appreciate the time. Thanks for being here today.
Absolutely. Let's do this again.